And the sad waiting game continues.
We grieve every day.
A missing mom's family just wants a proper goodbye.
From the station that's leading the way, News 5 at 11 starts now.
And tonight, that devastated family hoping for closure as crews continue their grim search in a local pond. Good evening, everybody. I'm Mike Dardis.
And good evening to you. I'm Cherie Pillow. Yes, Casey Pitzer disappeared in Wilmington. This was early Sunday morning after friends say she jumped out of a moving car on the way home from a bar. WLWT News 5's Jackie Conjato talked with her three sisters tonight.
Crews wrapped up this fifth day of searching around 8:30 tonight with nothing new to show for it, except frustration on behalf of searchers and family members.
It's like the waiting game.
32-year-old Casey Pitzer's three sisters are exhausted.
And we grieve every day, you know.
Their lives on hold, they've spent the better part of the last 5 days near this 8-acre Wilmington retention pond, waiting for word, hoping for finality.
And our frustrations come in when this is a pond, not a lake, not the Gulf of Mexico. This is a pond, and it's frustrating to be on day six.
Early Sunday morning, the search started after police say Pitzer left a nearby bar with two men and then got out of the car. Her boots were found floating on the surface of this drainage pond. And earlier this week, crews got a sonar image of a body in the water, but reaching it has been another story.
Once they go into the water, it's very dark. And a diver told me today that once they get in there, close your eyes, and it's like reaching out in the darkness.
Now pumps are working around the clock, but that presents another set of issues.
Every time we pump, the water's going to move. And so if there is something you're trying to find and you're locating it in that spot, it could move.
But these three sisters won't be going anywhere, not until they know for sure what happened to Casey.
We're back out every single day until she is out of that pond.
We're told a pump will continue to run overnight. Day six of this recovery effort will begin tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. In Wilmington, Jackie Conjato, WLWT News 5.
And the latest update from family members is that they've been able to drain a few feet of water from that pond so far, but rescue crews say the pond is about 35 feet deep. Also